It's your hockey nightcap from Vancouver, the Canucks against the Red Wings. Detroit coach Mike Babcock often has a very succinct way of summing up what he's thinking. And asked about the Red Wings and their long road trip that they're embarking on, he said, "We just got to try and figure out if we're good enough." And that pretty much sums up half the teams in the league at the halfway point, including Willie Desjardins and the Vancouver Canucks. They're just trying to figure out if they're good enough. It's an All-American matchup in goal again tonight. 2014 Olympian Jimmy Howard from Syracuse, New York, starts his fourth consecutive game, 12-5-2 against Vancouver. 2010 Olympian Ryan Miller making his sixth consecutive start, 2-10-2 in his career against the Red Wings. The referees tonight, Brad Watson, Frederick McQuie, Greg Dvorsky, and Jay Scherers. And as you might expect, when the Red Wings meet the Canucks, all the stars are on the ice. Henrik and Daniel Sedin with Radim Vrbata against Pavel Datsyuk, with Henrik Zetterberg, the Red Wing captain, on his left, and Justin Abdelkader on his right. The defensive pair that always play against the Sedins in these matchups, Nick Cronwall and Jonathan Erickson, who just moved the puck. Alex Edler and his partner Chris Tanev to play against Datsyuk's line. And here's the magician, Pavel Datsyuk. No magic there, though, as Henrik Sedin took the puck away from him. Fed it to Radim Vrbata. Daniel Sedin, here comes Alex Edler. Didn't get much of a shot away, and still it almost fooled Jimmy Howard. Verbata's shot, that tipped, and then was stopped by Jimmy Howard. Quickly on a line change, here comes Riley Sheahan. He's checked and knocked down, but in to get the puck, Thomas Tatar to Thomas Yurko. He shoots, and that was blocked by Tanev. What a frantic beginning to the game. Riley Sheahan with the two Thomases, Tatar and Yurko. Nick Bonino trying to get the puck out of his own zone with Chris Higgins and Yannick Hansen on Vancouver's second line has iced the puck.
As you mentioned, you expect some big things out of all this star power in the first shift of the game. But watch Daniel Sedin as he makes a nifty pass. He runs into Pavel Datsyuk. It hurt Datsyuk a little bit, also hurt Sedin. He took a while. Edler does an excellent job of jumping up with the play. One thing that makes defense so dangerous is both these centers and both these lines can fill catching a defenseman coming up on the play.
Mike Babcock wanting to get everybody into the game, and Helm takes a shot, so he's made quick changes here early on. He's got his third line out against Vancouver's second, and now Vancouver's making the defensive change. There comes Chris Higgins. Hansen drives the net. Puck is intercepted by Brendan Smith, and he knocked it into the corner. Johan Franzen playing on a line with Darren Helm. Drew Miller has just come on the ice. As the fourth line comes on already, a minute and a half in for Detroit. And the puck is dumped in by Nick Bonino, and Vancouver will start its next change.
Another collision. This time, Bieksa knocks over Weber as he's trying to jump on the ice.
There's Drew Miller on this very good fourth line for the Red Wings. Luke Glendening is the center. Steven Weiss normally would play further up the lineup, but as he gets back into National Hockey League form, he's playing in a fourth line role. Here's Glendening out of the University of Michigan. Caught from behind by Derek Dorsett as the puck is thrown to the net, and Miller steers it aside. Lucas Spezza working in the corner. Alex Burrows with Bo Horvat and Derek Dorsett in Vancouver's fourth line. And Dorsett tries to move the puck to Horvat. It does come outside the blue line. Trying to stand up there is young defenseman Xavier Ouellette, who's number 61, and he starts the change. Nick Cronwall will give this team lots of time, and the Canucks as well, to make the change.
You get a different forward matchup here as the Red Wings go with Datsyuk.
As Datsyuk shoots it wide, so Vancouver, with the option of the last change, looks like they may want to have Richardson's line play as a checking group with Mathias and Zach Cassian back in action for the first time since late November to play against Datsyuk, Zetterberg, and Abdelkader. That's a tough assignment. Cassian bounces the puck in. And Mike Babcock, already anticipating that the Sedins were going to come on, put his top D pair on, and now the Sedins come on to accommodate. Cronwall to Thomas Tatar. Yurko was ahead of him. Play was broken up, and the Sedins get the puck back. Vrbata left it behind. There's Danny DeKeyser has come on. Yurko is bumped at center. So there's a pretty good chess game going on here early.
Yeah, not unexpected given these two head coaches. An opportunity here going against Quincy and DeKeyser for the Sedin line.
There's Daniel Sedin. Danny DeKeyser on his offside. Kyle Quincy. Left the puck behind, and Riley Sheahan starts up. Sheahan and Glenn Denning have come on as youngsters to give the Red Wings incredible depth at center that they didn't think they had, and they're the best faceoff team in the NHL, an area where Vancouver is often nights left wanting.
Well, Daniel Sedin, good news for the Vancouver Canucks. Comes right back after that hit. Look at the middle of your screen there. It was not an intentional one. It looked almost like it hurt Datsyuk as much. He's trying to back pressure like he does so often. Goes around and a backward skating Daniel Sedin took a hard hit but came back for the next shift.
Fortunately, they've both been back in the game. Here's Chris Higgins driving in, and he forces Jimmy Howard to make a save. Higgins has all sorts of traffic in front. Plays back to the blue line. Nick Bonino filling in, takes the shot. It rattles off some legs and never did get to the net. Nick Cronwall moved it to the line. Alex Edler held it in, and Cronwall gets a do-over. Gustav Gus Nyquist. Up the middle, Darren Helm with Johan Franzen on their second shift of the game, playing against Bonino, Hanson, and Higgins. Chris Tanev, the center for Vancouver, dumps the puck in. There are lots of changes and short shifts early on, and so the pace of the game has been pretty good, and everybody's been into it. Steven Weiss advancing the puck as Drew Miller in front of his brother Ryan, and Ryan hangs onto that hard pass towards the net and stops playing.
That's a big game for Ryan Miller, getting back in the pipes. A disappointing loss on Thursday against the Los Angeles Kings with those late goals, and Kings do it again today, Jim. Three goals in a minute and 27 to come back and get a point out of Nashville. But for a goaltender, as Kelly Rudy would attest to, you have to have a short memory and erase it and get right back against a strong Detroit team.
After a spell where he and the team weren't very good, Ryan Miller's actually been pretty good in the last four.
Got his sharpness back, yeah.
Although the team's been outshot a lot. With the shots on goal 103-51 in their last three games, they might want to cut down on that.
I would say the message is get shots on net, too. Just 16 shots the last game.
That's what the Red Wings often do, fire from everywhere. Here's Jonathan Erickson, looks to the net, but he passed off. Justin Abdelkader, checked by Alex Edler. Datsyuk works the board, played the puck off the side of the net. And Edler on the shutdown pair with Chris Tanev, got himself into a little bit of trouble. Tanev helped him out, Henrik comes back in support. Some difficulty against a pretty good forecheck here, trying to get out of their own zone, and they're still not up. Thrown to the front of the net. Jumping in was Nicholas Cronwall. He'll cycle it back. Edler's going to get another chance to get out here. He's up against Abdelkader and Zetterberg. Radim Verbata this time comes back to help. And after at least three tries, Vancouver gets out.
One thing you notice from that shift is just how good their sticks are. Right? The one thing you have to be focused on is moving the puck quickly to get sticks in and turn pucks over.
Thomas Yurko, Tatar, streaks to the net. Miller with a good stick there. The goal stick to keep the puck away. Ouellette threw a puck at the net that went off a skate. In comes Brendan Smith, wrapped up by Alex Burrows. Defenseman is in deep. Yurko is a forward, helping him out at the blue line, and the Canucks would like to take advantage of that. Good sticks again all over the place, and the Red Wings keep the puck in. Derek Dorsett. Edler's got to get off. He's been out there for a while. Finally, Vancouver gets down into their attacking zone. A forecheck here by Bo Horvat. Brendan Smith, one of six left-handed defensemen on the Red Wings. Even when they call a guy up, he's a lefty.
There's only one right-handed player for Detroit in this game, and that's Glenn Denning. If he breaks a stick, he better get one from the trainer, one of his own, or otherwise he's playing with the wrong hand.
I hope he brought a lot on the road. Sean Mathias driving wide, shoots, and that hit Jimmy Howard in the mask or the throat, but it stayed out. Mathias with a good drive to the net. Kevin Bieksa just wide of the net, and the Canucks start to exert some pressure. Ryan Stanton wanted the puck. Brad Richardson kept it in. Danny DeKeyser knocked it out of the air, but he's in a battle with Mathias, and the puck is on the back of the net, stopping play. Quick 7 minutes in, three shots on each net, no goals. The biggest hit was an accident. Both players still in the game on Hockey Night in Canada.
And welcome back to Vancouver. And Dan Hamhuis, who hosted the Prince George Cougars during the LA game in his suite, has missed now 17 games due to a lower body injury. He has been skating and did so this morning about 10 o'clock in the morning. The only official word is that he is progressing, but he is hoping, and so is Jim Benning and Trevor Linden, that he'll be back before the All-Star break. Jim?
Canucks are 8-6-2 in his absence so far. Not bad when you consider, really like the Red Wings missing Nick Cronwall. It's a big loss. Glendening, Weiss, and Miller started in their own zone as they often do and got the puck into the attacking zone for Detroit. Miller tipped the puck back. Danny DeKeyser holds it in. Steven Weiss wrapped up along the boards. In a battle here with Nick Bonino, who's in support of his defense. Yannick Weber out of the blue line. DeKeyser's shot into traffic. Loose puck. Glendening bats away at it. Miller turns and fires, and that's deflected away as he bids again to score on his brother. Dangerous fourth line. DeKeyser, Glendening, Miller's out front. And the Canucks unable to touch the puck on this shift. Off the boards, Miller threw it in front. Here comes DeKeyser off the blue line. Can't take a shot, so he's going to do a lap, fed it out front. What a save by Miller off Miller. Ryan bested Drew. But it's Drew's line who bested the Canucks on this shift. If they had a little more finish, they wouldn't be a fourth line.
Boy, how about a little bit of trash talk from the brothers there? That was a robbery.
But that was a great shift, and that's why Mike Babcock so likes that line. They don't play as many minutes as the rest of the team, but they play a lot more than most fourth lines.
And I think where they started with a defensive zone faceoff after a commercial, which at times can be a vulnerable spot. Instead, they went down and kept the puck in for long stretches of time.
4 years the junior of his brother, the Vancouver goaltender. Here's Miller on Miller.
Where's the cross seam pass? He gets good positioning in front. DeKeyser with an aggressive move and right off the blocker. Almost a no-look save for Ryan Miller. 20 gets inside and then tries to tap it back out. Can't quite get the puck as he frustratedly goes back to the bench.
So with an attacking zone face-off, the Canucks come with their top line. Radim Verbata along the boards. Henrik Sedin battling against Cronwall to Daniel Sedin, who protects the puck. Back to Henrik. Up the outside, and the puck bounced to the blue line, and Edler couldn't hold it in. Another collision behind the play. It was Cronwall and Henrik Sedin this time. Justin Abdelkader. Red Wings are changing. Canucks are doing the same thing. Erickson saw them wave the flag. There's Slovak Thomas Yurko. Just off the bench, Thomas Tatar. He saw Stanton coming and he dumped the puck in. And when he did, he put the brakes on and put a teammate offside.
Well, always divided allegiances for the Miller family is Drew in a great position. He got the shot he wanted away. And Teresa Miller looking kind of feel bad one way, good the other. That's a natural reaction when either way, you know there's going to be one of them happy and one unhappy.
Looks like she's wearing her half and half Vancouver Detroit sweater again tonight. Dean and Teresa Miller here to watch their kids play against each other. Because of where Ryan has played, Drew's had the better of them in the last few years. 7-0-1 in their head-to-head matchups. From the blue line, here's Ryan Stanton with his shot. Blocked by Thomas Tatar, and then Stanton interfered with him. He's going to take a penalty. He tried to do it professionally and not take the call, but he knew he was in trouble. And Thomas Tatar blocked the shot. He limps to the bench, but he's drawn a penalty upcoming. And as Alex Burrows reaches and touches the puck, Detroit will go on the first power play of the game.
Well, worst feeling for a defenseman. You're focused on getting a puck through, and the one thing that the Red Wings forwards do very well is they block shots. You can see right on the top of the foot, Tatar gets right into the stick of Stanton. He's got his arms up immediately, but a tough call not to make for an official because it would have been a two-on-one going the other way.
Red Wing power play is a beauty. Their special teams have been excellent. Their power play is third in the league. 7 power play goals in the last 5 games. Datsyuk is out on it. Franzen, a net front presence. Justin Abdelkader can do that as well. Zetterberg and Cronwall. Vancouver's penalty killing has been very good, and it's fourth in the league. So if it turns into a special teams battle tonight, both ways, they're both excellent. Datsyuk. Johnson, Abdelkader, a bounce that went Detroit's way. Cronwall to Datsyuk to set up his hard pass and a good stick by Alex Edler. Kept that one from getting through. Brad Richardson and Chris Higgins just finish off the first part of the penalty kill.
Jim, sometimes when you've been so hot as a power play like the Red Wings are, you force things through, and that's exactly what Datsyuk wasn't patient, tried to force it through three guys, and now they're back killing off a lot of time.
Nick Bonino with Alex Burrows took the puck to the net, and the Red Wings are back in their own zone. Second power play unit came on in a hurry, so Babcock didn't like what he saw in the first one. Steven Weiss gets the puck in. The Kaiser can't hold the line. Thomas Tatar out with Riley Sheahan. Steven Weiss, Gus Nyquist, and Danny DeKaiser. Four forwards and a defenseman, same as the first unit. Nyquist, again, trying to force one into the middle, and Henrik Sedin blocked out. He and Daniel killing the penalty here. Here comes Henrik, wide on Sheahan. Rags the puck. Kept it at the line by Alex Edler, and he'll drop the puck off intentionally for Daniel just to work the clock.
I like the fact that despite the numbers of the Red Wings power play, this penalty kill that has been very good at a 92-plus clip over the last game has really been aggressive. They haven't allowed the setup that the Detroit Red Wings are looking for.
Here's Luke Glendening in the tail end of a power play. Yannick Hansen with a burst of speed, and Xavier Ouellette, the rookie in his 15th NHL game, made a play away from him.
What a good read by Ouellette to realize who it was. You got to understand who the speed factor is, and Hansen's one of the fastest, but he got there quickly.
Fans applaud the return of Ryan Stanford, or more appropriately, the play of the penalty killers while he was gone. Not a shot on that power play, but one of the best power play units in the league. Ouellette just up from Grand Rapids, born in France, grew up in Montreal. Father was a professional in Europe, and so he was born there, and they moved to Montreal where he played his minor hockey. Darren Helm darts in after the puck. Turns back, Abdelkader at the side of the net. Datsyuk is there as well, but the Canucks take the puck back. Out to center. Bo Horvat, chip and chase. He's got a man in front. He threw the puck in front for Derek Doucette. The puck was tipped away, and here comes Henrik Zetterberg back the other way. He's got Abdelkader with it. Tanev and Edler are back. The pace of this game has been so good. It must be tough on the benches to get the matchups you want in a game that is being played in such a hurry. Stutter step by Cronwall to lose Daniel Sedin. Jonathan Erickson, no look pass to Zetterberg. He got it by Edler. Turns looking for help, and he had it coming off the bench, but the puck's deflected right on Ryan Miller. 7-4, the shots in favor of the Red Wing. This game from Vancouver awaits its first goal on Hockey Night in Canada. Oppression and survival are at the heart of Lawrence Hill's The Book of Negroes. The six-part miniseries starring Lou Gossett Jr. and Cuba Gooding Jr. begins Wednesday night at 9 on CBC.
At the end of that successful kill, good aggressive forecheck here. Both D for the Red Wings think that Howard's going to play it, but look at the calm play by Nicholas Cromwell. Don't overplay it. Get fishing at the puck just calmly. Good active stick, and Zetterberg was back the other way. That's part of the trust factor between veteran players understanding body position and stick position, so important to defend.
Red Wings the best face-off team in the league. Vancouver 22nd, but they win this one. Henrik Sedin got some help from a winger and a defenseman. Still the Red Wings claim the puck. Riley Sheahan trying to get it. Thomas Yurko threw it towards the front of the net. Ryan Stanton was there to clear it. Vancouver has only won the faceoff battle in 14 of their 36 games. Something they'd like to change in the second half, but they're good to start tonight. 7-2 against the Red Wings.
You think of Nick Bonino coming in there, and it's been a bit of a drop-off in the faceoff department between he and Ryan Kessler.
It's really put a load on Henrik Sedin to take a lot of the draws.
And it becomes a difficult decision for Willie Desjardins of, you know, when do you get the minutes to back off on your top guy. It's such a luxury to have that good face-off man in either the third centerman role or even the fourth.
So, to your point, Craig, look what Mike Babcock can do right now. He has no hesitation to send Riley Sheahan or Luke Glendening out to take face-offs in his own zone. It doesn't have to overwork Zetterberg and Datsyuk. Another win for Vancouver for Richardson. Edler snaps the shot. Howard makes the save, and that's what a good faceoff win can do for you. A scoring chance for Vancouver.
Well, here's one that a very well-executed faceoff win, but Zach Cassian back in the lineup. And to me, just way too tentative to get to the front of the net. He gets boxed out going around the linesman and then gets knocked out by Kyle Quincy. That's got to be an aggressive play where you get inside position. You might get a deflection there. You might cause a rebound. Instead, he's a little bit slow and a little bit late getting to the net.
First game back after not playing in the month of December. Another faceoff win for Richardson. Adler's shot was blocked, and he turned and got back in a hurry. That one was blocked by Nyquist, and it hurt.
That one hurt him a bit too, didn't it?
After the puck, Sean Matthias. He's got a man in front. Couldn't get the puck by the young defenseman Ouellette. Here's Alex Edler on the other side. Chris Tanev tried to get his shot through. He did, but it was wide. And Nyquist moves the puck to Xavier Ouellette. Boy, good push here from Vancouver.
Another example of Ouellette's speed, though, there. He closed that gap quickly.
Yannick Weber is back. Nyquist is right on him. Cassian's pass into the feet of Alex Edler. He got it up to his stick. Sean Matthias, end of a shift, dumps the puck in deep.
Been a couple good shifts by Matthias there too. He'd like to get that line going again like they were a month or so ago.
You hit Cassian going on the other wing. You'd have two big wingers for Brad Richardson. He's had a good start to the night in the faceoff circle. Really, when you think about it, what you were saying about Cassian, nobody should be able to block him out from getting to the net.
That's part of the things that he needs to work on if you're talking to management, is understanding what you have to do to show the coach you should stay in the game. It's those moments where you just do what it takes to keep in the lineup. Hasn't quite figured that out on a regular basis yet.
Perfect example of that, this fourth line for the Detroit Red Wings getting another shift. Pavel Datsyuk coming out now. They took a short one.
And Jim, you know coaches are all about trust. They just got to trust that you're going to play in the right way at the right time.
Abdul Kader stole the puck. Centering pass. Nice recovery there. Bo Horvat, fourth line, out against Pavel Datsyuk. A sneak attack by Mike Babcock. And Horvat did a nice job of recovering after he got in a little trouble. There he is with the puck, threw it blindly in front of the net. Quickly cleared away, and Henrik Zetterberg has the puck. Vancouver's in the midst of a change to get the Sedins on in this matchup against Datsyuk. Henrik took the puck away from DeKeyser. Daniel trying to pull away from Zetterberg. He's got Henrik right behind him. Naturally, here comes Edler. Howard made a wonderful save. I think that was intended to be tipped. Alex Edler again. Chris Tanev in front. That was tipped. And blocked by Jonathan Erickson and cleared.
What a great read by Edler again to come up on that play. Two passes between the Sedins opened up the lane for Edler coming late.
They just wanted Henrik to tip that by Jimmy Howard, who made a terrific save. But the puck was still loose for a second. Long outlet pass for Nick Bonino. He'll have to chase Nicholas Cronwall. There's a giveaway and a great save by Howard. Erickson gave the puck away in front of the net. Higgins bats away at it. Can't get the puck to the net. Latter part of this period, Vancouver's really taken over. It's been a while since the Red Wings had a chance.
Some turnovers down low, too. They've really put pressure down below the Detroit net.
Vancouver's had a better forecheck. Bonino, Higgins, Hanson trying to keep that going. There's a turnover that allows Tatar to start out. He's got a defenseman, Brendan Smith, with it. Smith hard centering pass, it escaped. Kevin Bieksa turns the play the other way. Racing onto it is Yannick Hanson. Cuts to the net, couldn't get to the forehand for his shot, but he took Howard out. No penalty call on the play, although there might be afterwards with the battling in front.
Great aggressive play by Hanson. Use of his body to protect the puck. And although a difficult one to call, I think a good non-call, that's a good hockey play both ways.
Overall, a pretty even game, but Vancouver's been the better team in the last few minutes. Yannick Hanson taking the puck to the net against Jimmy Howard on hockey night. A couple of glorious chances for Vancouver to score. There are the guys who got the chances, but as always here, it starts with the Sedins.
Well, it starts with Henrik in his own zone, one pass. Daniel just waits for him to fill the lane, and this was a pass the whole way, trying to get it back down to the stick of Henrik Sedin. DeKeyser broke it up, and Nick Bonino, just one goal in his last 22 games, gets a gift, but what a reaction by Howard. And then look at all the white sweaters coming back to the front of the net as Bonino searches for that rebound.
Shots are 7-7. But the scoring chances we have at 6-2 Vancouver. Survival and triumph for the heart of Lawrence Hills. The Book of Negroes, a six-part miniseries starring Lou Gossett Jr. It begins Wednesday night at 9 on CBC. Richardson's been pretty good on the draws, and he's out here to take one against Darren Helm. Trying to win it on the forehand, and he gets kicked out.
3-0 so far, so he's been perfect.
Sean Mathias comes in. Saw. Winger win for Zach Cassian. Richardson, Mathias battles Helm in front of the goal. Kyle Quincy doesn't have a stick. Nice little play with his feet. Here in the NHL's Premiership. Adler cross ice pass. The Kaiser had a little trouble with it, but recovered to get the puck to center. Tipped through to Sean Mathias. Dropped it off to Cassian. Outside on Drew Miller. Trying to get his stick in there. Back to the blue line. The exit from Stanton right on, and Howard read that, got across and made the save. There was no screen, and the Red Wings are right back out to center. Drew Miller just about got nailed by Ryan Stanton. Luke Glendening to Miller. He shot it over top of the net. Again, Miller's in front, and he can't get another shot on Miller. I think that was the last Red Wings scoring chance, wasn't it, Miller on Miller?
Yeah, you think his brother's inside his head a little bit there. That one didn't even come close to hitting the net after he was robbed earlier. One thing that's been a constant in this early season for the Detroit Red Wings is Jimmy Howard. He's having a heck of a year, and he sees this puck the whole way. Cassian creates an opportunity to go side to side for the D, and this one point blank yet again. And Drew Miller can't get that one on his brother.
Through the uprights. Datsyuk beat Henrik Sedin in the draw, so Jonathan Erickson has the puck. Nick Cronwall takes over. Red Wings starting a long road trip. They'd be happy with a first period like this on the road, I think. Scoreless tie and a good bounce back period for Vancouver after a tough loss. Verbata with a shot that deflected off Jimmy Howard. And went out of play, and another chance for Vancouver on a good shot by Verbata.
Well, we've got an all-U.S. matchup in goal tonight with Ryan Miller and Jimmy Howard, and here's where Miller stands. He's climbing the ladder now. Tom Barrasso in his sights, and obviously the tops is Van Riemsdyk. You got to think it won't be that long before Ryan Miller can catch him.
If he gets it this season, they win the President's
Trophy. Yeah, I think they'll be pretty happy if he does that.
Missed fire at the blue line by Alex Edler. Playing his offside on the faceoff.
He gets that puck.
That was a good recovery. He was thinking about trying to get the puck through.
Edler and Tanev have been a very consistently excellent pair, he said, as they go chasing Henrik Zetterberg. Tanev, big help to his partner, both on the same side, sent the puck down the ice, and it's an icing call against Vancouver in the last 30 seconds of the period.
Jim, you bring back to a pairing, and part of the success of a pairing is understanding each other's tendency, and you just need to have repetition with that. Edler, as we've seen already tonight, jumping up offensively, he's got to know he can do that because Tanev can read it, and I think the fact that they've been able to stay together and play together has given them that success.
Red Wings got the draw, but it was too good. Split the defenseman, Smith and Ouellette. In comes Nyquist. Took a shot that deflected out of play with 18 seconds to go in the period.
Well, if I'm looking for a matchup on the road that Mike Babcock can try to win, it's to try to get Gus Nyquist in a favorable matchup. You have that ability to put both Datsyuk and Zetterberg and force the Vancouver Canucks to play a defensive pairing, and then this line has to come out and get something going like they have all year.
Nyquist taking Yurko's spot for a shift here. Thomas Tatar, Xavier Ouellette just trying to keep the puck in, and as Lucas Pisa gets a hold of the puck, Vancouver will start the breakout, but the first period comes to an end. Pretty good period for the Vancouver Canucks after a tough loss against Los Angeles. They outshot the Red Wings 9-7, had the more favorable chances to score, but Miller and Howard are perfect so far. Coming up on Hockey Night in Canada, it's George, Nick, Kelly, and Elliot. Hockey Night in Canada's first intermission on the nightcap coming up. Hockey Night in Canada continues from Vancouver, and the Detroit Red Wings and Canucks are scoreless into the second period. We probably shouldn't be too surprised at that, since both of these teams have had a little trouble scoring in their last 10 games. Played tight, low-scoring games. Vancouver, I think, will be pretty happy with the way they played that first period. They had a good pace. They didn't look slow, which is often why they're criticized lately. And they won most of the faceoffs, but there were only 17 of them in the period. Henrik Zetterberg in after the puck with Pavel Datsyuk and Justin Abdelkader. Zetterberg chopped at that, broke his stick. There'll be a Detroit penalty on the play. It was Zetterberg who broke the stick. Here's Edler, and he had his stick lifted by Justin Abdelkader. On the other side, Edler again. Chris Tanev, goaltender up for the extra attacker. Tanev, Radim Verbata to the front of the net, off some skates. Red Wings get the puck, and the Vancouver Canucks will get their first power play of the game.
It's Zetterberg coming back defensively, just gets the hack in. He wants the one-timer, it gets bouncing away, and there it is on the stick of Henrik Sedin. He knows it right away. Watch how slippery Datsyuk is. Stops for a second. Henrik thinks he's got him in his tracks. Instead, he's back the other way. What a great play defensively, Jim, by Abdelkader coming back. And once again, it was Edler jumping up in the play. Abdelkader maybe saved the goal.
That's why he gets to play on the first line. Because the Sedins were on, Vancouver starts its second power play unit. Bonino won the faceoff. There's another big win for Vancouver. Bieksa from the point. Bonino lost control of the puck for a second and was knocked away from it. Drew Miller and Luke Glendening often start the penalty kill, and here they are dumping the puck down the ice. So Bonino is up front with Derek Dorsett, Chris Higgins, Zach Cassian, and Kevin Bieksa. Cassian gets right onto a power play unit because of his size and strength, and he just about got the puck through to Derek Dorsett. Bonino to Bieksa. On the other side, Cassian with a shot. Just missed. And the puck comes all the way back down to the other end of the ice, and that'll start the change for the first power play unit to come on.
Yeah, wisely, that line doesn't stay too long, and overstay their welcome allows some freshness for the Sedins coming back.
Here comes Daniel with a slap shot. There's a rebound. Henrik had his stick tied up by Erickson. Back to Alexander Edler. Passes off. Daniel. Henrik. Edler fires. Scores! I think he probably talked it over in the first period and decided he better start shooting. He tried to pass in the first, and this time a shot has Vancouver out front 1-0.
Well, he can thank Burrows for making this possible. Watch the positioning of Howard in the crease. He's way back deep in his blue. He's got two bodies in front, his own defenseman, Cronwell, and Burrows in that position. It doesn't allow him to come out, take away the angle. He's late to reacting. Burrows makes sure he's outside of the blue. Doesn't get a point on it, but man, did he have an impact on that going in the back of the net.
Alex Edler's fourth of the season with the shot and the ice time that he has. You'd think he'd have more. 1-0 lead, and you heard Chris Tanev with Cassie in the first intermission talk about the Canucks taking their foot off the gas. Let's see how they do right away, because the Red Wings come back with a shift in the attacking zone. And they put Sheahan, Yurko, and Tatar on the ice, shift after a goal against. Dorsett. Nice pass into the middle. Bo Horvat missed the net. A wonderful opportunity for Bo Horvat to get his third, but it's still 1-0.
I keep in credit Yurko with getting a little bit of a stick in there on his hands at the very last second and forced him to miss the net.
Thomas Tatar out to center. Chips the puck by Ryan Stanton, heads for the bench and a change. Chris Tanev is back.
He's got the power play goal, the second power play that the Vancouver Canucks got in this game. They haven't had two power plays in four games.
Sean Mathias drives it in, tried to pass instead of shooting, and the puck didn't get to Brad Richardson. That's the third time in the game, though, that Mathias has made Detroit's defense look slow. Nyquist into Darren Hill. He's with Johan Franzen and Gus Nyquist. Canucks get the puck by them to center.
Great point, Jay. Willie Desjardins didn't feel that his team had much legs against Los Angeles. They weren't skating, they weren't pressuring the play. But here in the first period and a bit, they've done a much better job of getting in the rest of the
game. Bonino back. He puts Spezza in an uncomfortable position. He got tripped up by Nyquist. And Yannick Hansen saved any problems by taking the puck away, dumping it in. Bonino's in after it against Jonathan Erickson. Thrown back to the blue line. Here's Stanton with a shot. Another penalty coming up against the Red Wings here. And Vancouver's going right back on the power play with a 1-0 lead.
And it's the same byproduct of speed. It's stopping your legs moving. Erickson doesn't get in on the puck first. Instead, it's the speedy Hansen. It's been so far in this period. Bonino this time gets in. He's got follow support. And there's the stick into the hands of Bonino. Horvat showing great speed as well. Gets in alone. Watch the stick of number 26 just right on the hands at the last second affected Bo Horvat.
And to your point, Craig, if you're not playing a skating game, you don't draw penalties and get power plays, and the Canucks just haven't been able to get many.
They only had two power play chances in the last three games, and now already this is their third.
And they'll start that first unit that scored the goal. Henrik and Daniel set up Edler for the goal, and here's Alex Edler with the puck. The drop back, Henrik. Verbata with some speed in on Danny DeKeyser, threw the puck across the ice. Daniel for Henrik. Burrows heads for the front of the net. Edler's open at the blue line, takes the pass. Passes off to Verbata. He's on his offside, and he shot trying to be too fine. He missed on the short side.
You notice this time that Jimmy Howard had both D. Nobody standing next to Burrows. Just allowed Burrows to stand in there. Last time, Cronwall got too close.
Burrows to Verbata. And back, Burrows chops at the puck, and it comes over to Henrik Sedin. Daniel. Here's Alex Edler into the middle, passes off. Verbata wants to have Abdelkader come a little closer. Here's Burrows in front, and he shot up high. Might have been deflected, but it hit the glass and then hit the netting, stopping play.
Nominate your community at khv2015.ca by February 8th for your chance to be the next Kraft Hockeyville. Brought to you by Maxwell House Coffee.
Quick puck moving down low. Watch the kick out by Burrows. Takes one step back and tries to go top shelf, and that rolling puck just got away from him up and over the net.
Second power play units come on. With just less than a minute with which to work.
One thing you notice about that, though, is just the precision of the passing. A real quick, no hesitation on puck movement. Two passes, and it was a good attack on net.
Kevin Bieksa shoots the puck in for Chris Higgins to give chase. Bonino's there to help him. Cassian on the power play as the puck comes back to Kevin Bieksa. Cassian lost it in his feet, so Brendan Smith came right at him, knocked the puck loose, and Nick Cronwall sends it down the ice. Long change second period. Penalty killers hustle to the bench when they get the opportunity to change up. Derek Dorsett couldn't find a handle on the puck, and Darren Helm has it. Riley Sheahan snaps a shot, and Ryan Miller makes the save, but he's forced to take a faceoff in his own zone with 11 seconds left of the power play.
You notice a bit of a drop-off there. That second unit not able to get the speed through the neutral zone. A puck turned over, but on a good goaltender, you'll allow that shot anytime. For Sheahan, just get a puck on net. Make sure you don't miss the net there so it goes back the other way and the Canucks maybe get an odd man rush. Instead, you get Datsyuk and Zetterberg out on the ice to end this penalty kill.
Canucks get possession for a second. Datsyuk took it back and he hit the post. A steal by Datsyuk, and he just about made Vancouver pay.
And that's why. You make sure you get the whistle for that reason.
Just stole it again, but he couldn't set up Zetterberg. Off the boards, not out. The Red Wings keep the puck in. Another shot. Miller forced to make a save off Kyle Quincy. Sharp angle shot by Abdelkader was blocked. Five on five here now. Datsyuk to the front of the net. That's off Miller. And the Canucks get control now. Brad Richardson trying to chip the puck in his Bo Horvat. And Sean Mathias was just offside. It's a 1-0 lead for the Vancouver Canucks on the goal by Alex Edler, but Pavel Datsyuk stole the puck and came close off Miller and the post on Hockey Night in Canada.
Welcome back to Vancouver, and Mike Babcock, of course, won gold in 2010 in Vancouver and again in 2014. And there's the video coach from the 2014 Olympic team. He has now moved to the Detroit Red Wings. There he is in the warm-up. He's the video coach for the Detroit Red Wings. He moved his family this summer from Calgary to Detroit. And of course, there are a lot of Hockey Canada connections around the NHL, including Ben Cooper, the Canucks video coach, who also won gold with Babcock in 2010. Jim?
The spin-off of gold. pretty good jobs. Justin Abdelkader driving up the middle. A TV timeout, so the top lines are on against each other. Vaughn Waldo Erickson. Henrik Zetterberg, ring wide. Datsyuk off the boards, chased the puck, but he couldn't quite get it. Kostanev. Henrik Sedin back to help out. His pass up the middle didn't get to Daniel, who pursues it now against Cronwall. Verbata came to help out, and they got the puck back. Datsyuk. In comes Edler. Oh, he just about nailed him. Datsyuk turned and saw Edler just in time. Game on.
Well, just when Datsyuk looked down for the puck, Edler read it perfectly, timed it, and then at the last second, Datsyuk looked up and just avoided the collision.
Nyquist with the tip-in. This was Detroit's best line in their last game against New Jersey to win. Helm had two goals. Johan Franzen, in the words of Mike Babcock, had his best game in a long, long time. And Nyquist, they've been quiet tonight. Here's Yannick Hansen into the middle. Chris Higgins shoots, deflected right on. Howard's got it, or does he? Now he's got a hold of it. He might have made the save easier had the puck not been deflected in front when Higgins took the shot.
Boy, there are some collisions on the ice that happened. We saw earlier. Look at Datsyuk. Thinks he has time. He looked two quick peeks to see if Edler was going to come back, but how about his partner? Zetterberg comes right back at Edler and goes right after Daniel Sedin as well. So collision just missed at one end and a response at the other.
False start off the faceoff. That's Alex Edler at his best.
He's been aggressive both offensively, jumping up, and there's another one without the puck. How that aggressiveness can pay off as well.
That overused and underrated word, confidence.
Cassie was talking about Mike Babcock, and interesting, Jim, he's the longest tenured coach in the National Hockey League, his 10th year. But amazingly, he's had 10 different assistants during that time. And that's one of the things I think that's helped not have his message go cold on this team. Lots of different voices over those 10 years.
There's Yannick Weber. Geez, he must be a hard guy to work for.
Yeah, exactly. Three of them have become head coaches, and Todd McClellan, Paul McClain, and most recently Peters in Carolina. But
here's Chris Higgins for Vancouver to Yannick Hansen. Nick Bonino, the trailer wasn't quick enough. Caught by Riley Sheehan, so he couldn't get the shot. Thomas Yurko has to make a move on a pinching defenseman, and he does, and gets the puck by him, but it'll be an icing call as Lucas Spisa gets back. And the Canucks have played the game at a different pace tonight because they knew the Red Wings would push it.
Well, the Red Wings have had nothing but success under Mike Babcock, and if I'm a coach in the National Hockey League, I'm calling Mike and saying, listen, hold out to become an unrestricted free agent at the end of this year. Try to drive the price up for a head coach, as he has lots of opportunity, lots of talk of not having a contract done till the end of the season, but he'll have plenty of callers, I can guarantee you that.
Isaac and Quincy off the one faceoff. Here again, the Canucks have had a very good forecheck tonight. And they're having it again here. DeKeyser had trouble getting out of his own end. He just about iced it again. Kevin Bieksa is back.
Don't you feel they feel a little more comfortable with a goal or two more, though? You know this Detroit team can stay in the game and be dangerous when they get their chance.
An offside call. The play exchange is a national call to action encouraging healthy lifestyles. Meet six finalists and vote on the program you feel deserves $1 million to fund the idea. Tune in Friday night at 7 on CBC. Red Wings usually spread some scoring around. Datsyuk and Zetterberg haven't been as hot lately, so they've only got 20 goals in their last 10 games. Vancouver at 23. So you don't want to give up three tonight. Steven Weiss watching Lucas Spisa. Fourth line shift, both teams. Although the way this Glendening line plays, it often becomes the third line for Detroit. Burrows with Bo Horvat in front. The puck comes back to Weber. His shot deflected just wide. Horvat got a touch on that. And it went into the corner. Steven Weiss. Lucas Spisa trying to hold the line. The play's offside.
One thing against a goaltender like Jimmy Howard is you want to get traffic in front. There's never a bad play, a good aggressive drive wide by Burrows, but look at how quickly he gets back to the front of the net. Horvat in there as well, and this is a shot by Weber that's more just going into traffic. That actually hits Smith's stick in front and just barely misses the outside as Howard watched it go by him.
As Kevin Bieksa and Yannick Weber talk things over on the bench, the linesman had to fix a little hole next to Jimmy Howard's goal crease. Back to the top lines. Sean Wall for Zetterberg, didn't connect. So Tanev set it back the other way for a moment. A swarm of Red Wings, three of them on Henrik at the blue line. Even he couldn't get through. Like a rugby scrum, and the Red Wings got the puck. Conwall forced back by Verbaugh. The four Canucks are already back in the neutral zone, skating backwards. Zetterberg, no choice but to shoot the puck in. The Red Wings have long been reluctant to do that. Edler to Daniel, and out. And Vancouver wants to start a change. Jonathan Erickson sees his mates doing the same thing. Abdelkader didn't touch that to tip it in, so in the midst of a change, there's an icing call.
Well, a veteran like Henrik Sedin understands that you better not turn the puck over in this area. So he quickly gets back after Pavel Datsyuk and dangerously almost put his hand on top of the puck. If you saw Abdelkader there, he was trying to get a call. Did a nice job of instinctively making sure he just bumped it and didn't put the hand right on top.
Canucks win another faceoff. Yannick Hansen's centering pass was blocked. This is an icing call, a disjointed Red Wing line on the ice. Zetterberg gets the puck down the ice. He wanted to put it right on goal. He got the desired effect because Bieksa had to play it. And the change is complete.
Yeah.
Ryan Stanton. Pass up the middle. Bieksa, the other defenseman, is right there. Dropped the puck off. Foligno's shot steered aside by Howard. Higgins. To the blue line, Ryan Stanton, rolling puck, and that tipped off a stick and wide. Hansen in against Nyquist, who chopped the puck, didn't get it out. Higgins filling in on the defense. After Hansen had done the same thing. Ryan Stanton deep on the left wing. Nyquist got the puck out of that scrum along the boards. Bieksa is back, and he comes over and pushes Nyquist off the puck and gives it to Ryan Stanton. To Foligno. Good play by Brendan Smith to hold the puck in. Riley Sheahan trying to get through the middle. Gustav Nyquist to Smith on the other side. One-timer from Quincy went just wide of the net. Make that Xavier Ouellette. There's a shot by Tatar. Stopped by Ryan Miller. And the rebound gets to Higgins and he clears it. Sheahan in forechecking again. Tatar follows him and gets the puck. Brendan Smith is behind him. The puck got away. Here's Sean Matthias. Up the middle, trying to split the defense, and he's going to draw a penalty, or is it a penalty shot? Penalty all the way.
It's going to be Smith before that he was able to get to the puck. I think Smith, if he had realized Ouellette was the one coming, he should have let him go. He was going to catch him.
Vancouver's power play is 1-for-2, and it's going to work with a 1-0 lead next. Brendan Smith takes the penalty, but maybe he should have trusted his rookie partner.
Well, at times you don't necessarily have that trust, and he's going to argue this call as he gets the stick in there. Mathias is probably not going to win the battle, but he does a good job of staying with it. And then when you get to the bench, I can tell you from personal experience, I've had many of these discussions, and I think I'm batting zero on that one. You're not going to win the argument.
Well, you're always hoping to win one down the road.
Yeah, somewhere along the line.
Canucks on the power play, winning the draw. There's the shot by Edler, and it's stopped by Jimmy Howard. Daniel Sedin. Boy, the Canucks have been sharp in the faceoff circle. Henrik, Daniel, Edler, Verbatov shoots, and Howard makes another save with Burrows parked in front. Daniel, Edler, this time he takes a shot that's knocked down, and Glendening gets out with Drew Miller, and they want to change, so they just dump the puck in.
There's two sharp saves by Howard with, once again, some traffic in front of him. More positional saves than reacting to it.
Edler with a drop back. Henrik to Daniel. Waiting, and he throws the puck back to Edler. Got Verbata beside him. Throws the puck into the corner. Henrik. Daniel. Burrows took a whack in front from Kyle Quincy. Sedin's again. Daniel shoots. Oh, he just missed. Abdelkader's after the puck. Turns and fires to Darren Helm. Good defensive play by Abdelkader, and here's Helm. Going to go for a skate. Hopecheck, his teammates are changing. Henrik's trying to take advantage, and a good recovery by Darren Helm to delay things. Alex Hedler, Henrik to Daniel, back for Alex Hedler, busting through the middle, and he couldn't get the puck to the net. Henrik to Daniel, he wanted it, you heard him, and then he threw it back to the open side, and the puck comes all the way out to center. Second power play unit, Kevin Bieksa. Weber, Nick Bonino, threw the puck back, that's just onside. Bieksa held the line. Cassian's after the puck on the right side. Advances it behind the net. Erickson trying to get a hold of it. Double team Higgins, and Bonino knocked him down. Cornwall moved the puck, and it stops at the point. Zach Cassian. Chris Higgins, he's got a screen. Smith's out of the penalty box. The one-timer, Bieksa, stop. Another shot by Bieksa, knocked it out of the air, wide and into the corner. Kevin Bieksa again as the pressure continues, even though it's 5-on-5. Higgins fights off Erickson. Trying to fight off Miller, can't do it. Brendan Smith out to center. Here's Luke Glendening. In on Kevin Bieksa. Takes the shot that's partially blocked. And Bieksa's back for the puck. He gave it away to Riley Sheahan. He'll feed it back to Danny DeKeyser, who takes the shot. Knocked down in front of the net by Nick Bonino. And again, the Canucks can't get out. Riley Sheahan kept it in again. Tatar's behind the net. Yurko's out front. Tatar hit the outside of the post. Bonino to Derek Dorsett. Canucks need to finish a change after the power play, and as the puck is knocked out of play by Kyle Quincy, they'll get that opportunity. Still a 1-0 lead for Vancouver. They failed on the latest power play on Hockey Night in Canada. Hank and Dan with some good crisp puck movement again, but fell short in the power play.
Well, they're communicating on the bench, maybe talking over this. A nice little hesitation down low, good pass, and Daniel just barely missed to the outside. Once again, crisp movement, the end of the power play, a one-timer by Bieksa that Howard had trouble with traffic in front. And there are times when a power play not scoring can really derail you and take away momentum. That was not one of them. That was a very crisp power play that had some really good scoring chances.
Crisp is a good word to describe the game.
There are times when you're just off and you're hesitant, and boy, both these teams look sharp. Their last shift by Detroit after that penalty kill was pretty sharp as well. They had a couple good chances at the net.
Nick Cromwell is back to Jonathan Erickson. Crossed up Zetterberg, so the puck goes to Vancouver, and Chris Tanev dumps it in. Cronwall to Pavel Datsyuk. Abdelkader's on his right and takes the pass. Datsyuk to the net, tip right on, what a save! And a quick whistle after a tremendous save by Ryan Miller.
Well, you said sharp, and this is an example of sharp. A backhand, no-look pass by Cronwall to a breaking Datsyuk. No hesitation. Drive the middle, give it to the outside. And the whistle came very quickly as the official thought Miller had it. A nice pass by Abdelkader, a reflex save by Miller. But on the doorstep was Zetterberg for that loose puck. And he was arguing the call, the whistle shouldn't have been made.
Darren Helm to his forehand, won the draw. Xavier Ouellette just about got crossed up there against Sean Mathias. And he's able to keep the puck in. Ouellette calmly again stands up at the blue line to hold the puck in. And on the third time, can't handle it against Sean Mathias. Got back and got it though. Helm right back in. Johan Franzen cuts to the middle and shoots. Steered aside easily. Thomas Yurko. Darren Helm, Franzen's in front. Bouncing puck, Helm couldn't get it to him quick enough. But they'll play the cycle game here. Franzen cross ice, back door. Here's Smith, can't slide the puck in front. Stanton got a piece of it. Smith back to the blue line. Xavier Ouellette takes the shot. That's blocked, and now he's in trouble. Here's Mathias. Ouellette is back. Horvat is coming. Red Wings take it away. Brendan Smith to the net. Stopped Miller, thrown in front by Yurko and cleared away. And here come the Canucks. It's their turn. But there's a penalty on the play, behind the play.
He's giving it both.
They're both going to go.
You know what? This is a call that at the last minute, looking up, I think when the official, it was
number
the QA, realized what he actually saw, he ended up calling a dive end. Now, this should be a non-call. It's a drop pass. Smith jumps up, just tries to throw it on net. Now watch in the corner afterwards as Cassian goes for the puck. You're right, it was a dive. I don't think it deserved a hook.
Oh, a beauty too.
I know, and his arm went up originally, and I think he had time to at least think about what he saw. And so four on four instead of a power play, and Franzen is chirping the other side on Cassian.
At least they caught the embellishment after the fact, if that was the case. But Franzen goes for tripping, Cassian for embellishment. And he might get a call about that one.
Yeah, that's a definite dive, that one.
1.5 Gainer with a twist.
Biggest guy on the ice.
So 4-on-4 for the first time in the game.
So
Daniel and Henrik are on the ice. Henrik's after the puck. Datsyuk and Zetterberg. What a load of talent out here right now. Daniel. Great control in traffic. Henrik. Pushed from behind by Eriksson. Undaunted gets the puck back. Daniel couldn't deal with it against Cronwall. Now it's Datsyuk's turn. What a pass to Zetterberg. Stops and shoots. Miller with a save. To Kaiser with a shot and a wonderful save by Ryan Miller. And back the other way comes Henrik Sedin.
What a play by Datsyuk, though. A little flip up with the puck away from traffic. Knocked it ahead to him. And then a perfect pass cross ice. Holy cow.
Danny to Kaiser. A great save Miller made on him. Sheahan cuts to the middle, shoots, and he just missed. Terrific job to make sure his stick wasn't checked. He had it in the air and tracked the puck and stayed with it. Got him for Patanau. Out to center. Turned back by the Red Wings. Here's Brendan Smith. Got unchecked for a second, but couldn't keep the puck. Thomas Tatar gets it. On the other side, here's Ulette with a shot. Up high, missed the net. Brendan Smith from the other side. Feeds the puck into Riley Sheahan. He'll hold it in for Brendan Smith. Xavier Ulette wanted it. The shot went wide. And bounced to Lucas Spezza for Vancouver. And he slows things down just a bit with 10 seconds to go in the penalties.
Well, if you've heard the saying, puck control teams, boy, these are two good examples of it, aren't they? They can handle it in pressure and make plays under duress, both sides.
Cassian steps out of the penalty box, chased by Franzen, and Franzen won the day there. He got his stick on the stick of Cassian, and no shot. Xavier Ouellette, 21-year-old rookie, dumps the puck in. Kevin BX is back, chased by Justin Abdelkader. Quickly breaking out is Yannick Hansen. Through the middle is Chris Higgins. BX is with him, headed for the front of the net. And the pass went off a stick and out of play with under 2 minutes to go in the second period.
Over the course of his career, he almost run out of superlatives to explain just the things that this guy can do with the puck. A little chip up here as he felt pressure, and then makes a perfect pass, goes hard to the net. Danny DeKeyser popping up. The rebound was there for a second. Miller got square to it, and boy, couldn't catch it, but he was able to get the block. Sheahan showing his speed and just barely missed on the outside there. Great action, 4-on-4.
Red Wings get the draw in their own zone. Jonathan Eriksson has the puck. Backhand scoop to center. Is knocked down, and the Canucks come right back in. Bieksa jumps up. Cronwall, bouncing puck to Eriksson, and that bouncing puck got him in trouble. He gets some help from Drew Miller, who backhands the puck out to center, but it must have hit a glove at that Vancouver bench. The play exchange is a national call to action encouraging healthy lifestyles. Meet six finalists and vote on the program you feel deserves $1 million. Tune in Friday night at 7 on CBC. So the Red Wings come to town wanting a good positive start with 17 of the next 23 games on the road, a six-game road trip. The Canucks are angry with themselves for losing a game against LA, and they're on a homestand, and the two coming together tonight with something to prove
It's lived up to its billing, hasn't it?
It's made it a pretty good hockey game, hasn't it?
It's been a good battle both ways.
No turkey legs tonight. Abdelkader, Zetterberg in the slot, couldn't get the shot. Trying to keep possession here. That's it. Edler swept the puck away from him. Burrows with a trusting play, now he chases the puck. And Erickson with that long stride got there first. So it's back the other way for the Red Wings. That's it. Zetterberg cut across in front of him. Abdelkader can't get the shot. Tanev looked after that. And he goes in after the puck, deferring to Datsyuk, as anyone in his line probably should. Tanev fights the puck to center. Henrik Sedin, the last half a minute of the second period. Shots are 18-16 favoring the Red Wings. Vancouver has the lead on Alex Edler's power play goal a minute 48 seconds into this period. Maddie DeKeyser up the middle. Tip through Thomas Tatar, looking around as he gets to the puck. Couldn't throw it in front against Spezza. Daniel Sedin is back. Madden for Battle. Kevin Bieksa checked the clock before he looked down at the puck. Henrik Sedin fed it back to Spezza, and that's it for the second period. Canucks will go into the third period with the lead. That loss against Los Angeles the other night is the first time this season they've lost with a lead into the third, and they don't want that to happen tonight. George and Company next on Hockey Night.
This period brought to you by the all-new 2015 Sonata with available forward collision warning from Hyundai.
Welcome back inside Rogers Arena, where Alex Edler, a power play goal, has made it 1-0 for the Canucks after two. And Willie Desjardins and Ben Cooper are known to put a few little surprises in the video sessions for the Canucks guys. And one of the more recent ones was adding Susan Boyle's first ever performance from Britain's Got Talent, where she's saying, "I had a dream of a dream," from Les Miserables. He shocked the dressing room. The guys were all laughing about it, but the message was clear that the Canucks always need to add an element of surprise to every game and never take anything for granted. Jim?
Who's the superstar singer tonight? So far, Alex Edler has the only goal in a game that hasn't had an awful lot of hits, but it's had a ton of scoring chances. Great passing, a well-played game between Detroit and Vancouver. There's Abdelkader with a shot off the draw to start the third period. As the top two lines match up as they have most of the evening. Daniel Sedin advances the puck for Verbata to give chase. Cronwall got back. Datsyuk in perfect position. The second relay just about got intercepted. Tanev from the blue line. His shot hit Pavel Datsyuk. Here's Henrik Sedin in front. Just missed Verbata and Daniel. Zetterberg, he just missed Datsyuk, so Henrik has the puck. Daniel Sedin leaves it for Henrik. Verbata trying to poke that puck back, and Henrik got spilled in a battle with Jonathan Erickson. And he's slow to get up, probably because it's the end of a shift.
And both sides are so used to playing against that style in practice that you notice that they were intercepting each other's passes. It's interesting how similar those two top lines, their style of play and puck handling is.
It's like they're playing a game of Twister all the time. Nick Foligno in after the puck against Danny DeKeyser. The centering pass and a quick shot missed short side. Back to the blue line. Stanton's shot that went off a body and just wide of the net. DeKeyser slowly out to center Kyle Quincy. An indirect pass to Gustav Nyquist. Now Riley Sheahan. Nyquist off the boards. Forced to cycle back to Tatar to Nyquist. There's going to be a penalty here against Vancouver. Nyquist didn't get the shot, but he drew a penalty. DeKeyser's shot stopped by Ryan Miller. And there again, some terrific play and passing along the boards. Doesn't create a goal, but it created a penalty.
No, and this is one of the depth positions for the Red Wings, is having Nyquist come out after that top line. He gets inside positioning on Stanton. Only one player for the forwards of the Detroit Red Wings have played less than Nyquist. I think he's one of those guys that kind of got lost in the shuffle in periods one and two, and already his first shift creates a power play chance.
So they move him up with Sheahan and Tatar and move Yurko back. I guess they don't necessarily like what they're getting out of Helm and Franzen tonight.
Vancouver, number 18,
Zetterberg starts things off the draw with Abdelkader, Franzen, and Datsyuk, all of them in deep. The lone man back is Cronwall, and he has the puck. Screen set up by Abdelkader. Pavel Datsyuk, turned away by Tan Evan Burrows. Johan Franzen, Cronwall, Franzen, one-timer, hit his own man in front of the net. Datsyuk. Going up the middle, Cronwall just holds the line, and he passes off to Pavel Datsyuk. Back to Cronwall, he shoots, that's blocked. Good block by Bonino, right in front, great save by Miller on Pavel Datsyuk. Here's Cronwall, might have to make another one. Franzen works towards the front of the net, his shot was blocked, it didn't get through. Right in front, Datsyuk, great save by Miller, another one.
Jim, even Datsyuk can't believe that puck just got through to him. He was shocked that he was even able to get a shot away. Twice now, he's the one going to the net. The second one here, you can see through a crowd, he was in great position, but did not get the shot that he wanted. Here's another one in traffic that Miller just fought through the screen of Abdelkader, got across and got his leg down. Two great chances from the top players of the Wings.
First one was the most difficult one, I think. That's six shots now for Pavel Datsyuk. Six of 22.
That last one, though, was such a crisp, hard pass. No look from the corner. He didn't get anywhere near the shot I think he would have normally have had if he tracked it the whole way.
Nyquist on a second power play unit. He's up with Tatar, Stephen Weiss, Riley Sheehan. Lone defenseman is Danny DeKeyser. He takes the pass at the blue line. Had to be quick. Nyquist. Turned back by Brad Richardson, the pass into the middle, tipped back to Kaiser, shoots, that hit a man in front, and the rebound is cleared by Chris Higgins. DeKeyser again. Last half a minute of the power play, Tatar was hooked back, no call, and Henrik Sedin has the puck. Short-handed breakaway, stopped by Jimmy Howard. Henrik Sedin has been stuck at 199 goals for 13 games. Here comes Nyquist. And now there's going to be a penalty call after the first one was let go.
Well, here's why the Red Wing bench was up in arms originally. It almost ended up in a goal in their net. This is the original one right there. Stick in the arms as Tatar gets losing the puck. Goes back the other way. Henrik Sedin bats it down, gets in all alone. Credit Howard with fighting this one across. So the second time down the ice, maybe as much, it's Daniel this time, and Daniel gets called.
So 7 seconds left in the penalty to stand, and a 5-on-3 that will really only take effect if they win the draw.
And what a veteran play by Howard here, saying, oh, I got a little bit of, when I skated to the bench with the arm up, you know what, I got a little bit of a edge loss. Buying what, at least 15, 20 more seconds?
So Datsyuk gets a breather. They get a little huddle. Frederick Lecuille says, let's get out of here. That's a big faceoff win for Nick Bonino. 5-on-3, and the puck is smothered in the corner accidentally on purpose, and it'll get it down to 2 seconds before the Stanton penalty is expired.
I think Abdelkader is probably as happy as Edler is the fact that he lost his stick. He got blown up trying to get to that loose puck. But a huge win on the draw for Nick Bonino there.
Vancouver's won 55% of the draws tonight. They've had a pretty good night in the faceoff circle against the best team in the league at winning faceoffs. Now he needs to win another against Datsyuk. Red Wings got this one back. Cronwall into the middle. One penalty is over, but the Red Wings have the puck. Henrik Zetterberg, Abdelkader in front, Franzen in front. Datsyuk hovering around. Great work along the boards. Bonino couldn't get the puck out. Franzen. Nick Cronwall into the corner to Henrik Zetterberg. Datsyuk wanted the puck. Probably still does. There's the back door play and ricochet twice. Franzen. Cronwall. Johan Franzen shoots. He missed the net by a mile. After the puck is Brad Richardson. He got there first. Gets the puck down the ice and a penalty collision changing up. Zetterberg had the puck get away from him. Franzen had to leave it. It would have been offside.
That's just a killer play by Franzen, though. You can't miss the net there. Everybody's attacking down the lane, trying to get a rebound instead. Now 35 seconds later, you still don't have control.
Howard had to play the puck because his defensemen were changing, and Mathias would have had it. Now Mathias comes after Nyquist. Tatar, nifty little play to Weiss. On the other side, Sheehan shoots. He missed the net. Nyquist. Turned away from Matthias. Waits back for the up. Setup. Shane goes to the side of the net. Tatar's over on the other side. That pass was for Weiss and he wasn't ready. Tatar blocked once. Good play by Yannick Hansen and Matthias to get the puck out. Half a minute to go with the latest Red Wing power play, their third of the game. Sheehan, Nyquist, Riley Sheehan, Stephen Weiss parked at the top of the crease. Pass comes back to Thomas, Tatar, to Kaiser, neglected to shoot. Nyquist, in comes Tatar on the back door. Nyquist in front, Weiss stopped once, twice. Puck is still loose, Tatar can't get it. And it's bunted back by Spezza to Miller so he can cover it. And it was still loose when the whistle went.
An anxious moment there for Ryan Miller. I think it just does, the only thing you can do as a goalie there is batten down the hatches low. Don't allow anything to get between your legs. A good aggressive play at the net. Weiss has a chance to turn around and try to get it up. Instead, Miller makes the first save and then watch him get the paddle down. Stay down low, couple of whacks at it. He's able to hold on, and then Kevin Bieksa comes in here and just blows out the front of the net.
So with 5 seconds to go in the penalty to Daniel Sedin, the Red Wings have had 6 shots on 2 power plays and haven't been able to beat Ryan Miller. And the shots are now 25-17 favoring the Red Wings. Thanks to these last couple of power plays. Luke Glendening won the latest faceoff. Jonathan Erickson. Here's Drew Miller in on his brother, and that's turned back. He was trying to pass, and Ryan Stanton blocked it and got the puck to center.
Really good timing by Stanton there. He timed his chance to go down, got the stick flat on the ice, and didn't allow the pass across.
5-on-5 again. Red Wings 0-for-3 with a man advantage, and the last couple of kills, you can credit Ryan Miller for a tremendous job, a goaltending clinic in the third period, and now it's 5-on-5 with 6 minutes gone in the period.
Well, anxious moments for the former Michigan State Spartans, both of them, Drew and Ryan, and that was the great defensive effort by Stanton. Some anxious moments. You want maybe a tie game to make everybody happy at some point. I'm sure she's done that thousands of times over their career.
Helm won the draw. Brendan Smith, poke check. Yannick Hansen's trying to get away from him. Had to kick the puck up, threw it into the middle. And Thomas Yurko's there to play the puck to Brendan Smith. His pass is an errant one, and there's an icing call against the Detroit Red Wings. Some entrepreneurs just won't take no for an answer. And thanks to the second chance special, they'll get another shot at scoring a lucrative deal on Dragon's Den.
And Jim, no hesitation by Willie Desjardins. You don't even have to tell the Sedins on that. You get an icing call, you get a chance to catch a line out there, and the Sedins come flying out.
Henrik against Darren Helm on the faceoff. Helm got it back. Smith, Johan Franzen, and Thomas Yurko. Playing together as Nyquist has moved to Shane's line. Here's Yurko. Looked up and had his pocket picked, and Lucas Spezza has the puck. Henrik, Verbata up for Daniel. Cronwall gave him no space in the neutral zone. Still doesn't. Then he got the puck through to Verbata. Now there's a little room. Henrik trailing. Verbata's shot stopped by Howard. Henrik Zetterberg to an open wing. Nobody's there. Chris Tanev. Brad Richardson at center backhands the puck in for Vancouver. Matthias has been flying tonight. Gets him in a hurry. Poked the puck away from Erickson. Richardson took it. Cassian's in the slot. Conwell comes back to help his partner. Tried to thread the needle, and he did get the puck through the advocator eventually. Jonathan Erickson to Henrik Zetterberg. Edler stands up on him in the neutral zone. Datsyuk takes over, but he's 1-on-3. Bounced against the boards by Zach Cassian. He didn't like it either. Edler. Two little passes and out for Vancouver. Close call. Fans didn't like that icing call, as DeKaiser was just slow enough to make sure that it was, and Vancouver has to find that group and get them back on again. Where the referee has to find the group that was on the ice.
And the fact that it's Richardson out there for the Vancouver Canucks. Helps a little bit. He's been solid again all night long, 56% on the draws, and he's taking his time to get a little bit of a breather.
That Zook's line had been on, so they couldn't stay here. They just left. Richardson and Shane, another big win for Brad Richardson tonight. Up the boards. Richardson gets a lucky bounce. Gets to center, dumps the puck in. Disaster averted on an icing call. Danny DeKeyser slipped and fell. Shooting by Thomas Tatar. Here's Kevin Bieksa back for Vancouver. That was tipped. Smith keeps it in with a shot. Blocked in front of the net by Bieksa. And Chris Higgins takes over for the Canucks. He'll turn and fire the puck across the ice. And this will be an icing call as well as Xavier Ouellette gets back for Detroit.
This is one of those scenarios as the ice has started to tilt a little bit. The shots are getting up. 26-17 now for Detroit. And you have to erase the memory banks of their last game where they weren't able to hold the lead late. Miller's been extremely sharp, but he was again on Thursday night as well before Williams beat him late and then stole for the winner.
Here's another chance coming up. Centering pass. How did that one get to the back of the net off the stick of Thomas Yurko up the middle? Kevin Bieksa joining the rush, leading it against Xavier Ouellette. Nick Bonino is back. Brendan Smith guarded the puck loose. Franzen tried to clear it. Bieksa kept it in with a good play of the line.
At least Mom Miller was able to celebrate that one. It wasn't her son. Yeah. Her other son that had the shot. What a save.
Johnson now 20-8, 20-9 now in favor of Detroit since the first period. Half a dozen of those came on early power plays in this period, though. But the momentum turned to Detroit's side after two straight power plays.
There's no question that Mike Babcock's got to be happy with the response of his team in the first game of a road trip, as Cassie was talking about. They've been battling.
Now the Canucks have to snatch some momentum back. A tip in by Steven Weiss. And Ryan Miller stops play. Let's have a look at the latest bit of handiwork for Ryan Miller on Thomas Yurko. A bouncing puck in front, and Ryan Miller, that must look like a beach ball tonight.
Time for the Budweiser Red Light scoreboard. Bobby Ryan, the winner for Ottawa in Boston. Winnipeg 5-1 over Toronto. David Perron scores his first game with Pittsburgh, but not enough as they lose 4-1. Jaromir Jagr, a hat trick for New Jersey over Philly. No Claude Giroux in that game. Dallas 7-1 over Minnie, and it's 3-2 in San Jose. TJ Oshie has two for St. Louis. Jim?
Here, Cassie, Alexander Edler has the only goal, his fourth of the season on a second period power play, and Vancouver's now been outshot by 60 over their last four games. And they need to tilt the ice back the other way. Red Wings want a draw. They're starting to do more of that in the third period as well. Although there was a couple of big wins shorthanded for Vancouver. Top line's out again. Icing's waved off. Good curling shot by Chris Tanev. Alex Edler awaits the arrival of the puck in the neutral zone and gave it to Radim Verbata. Back to Edler, who wanted to screen, but he finally decided he better just shoot it, and now it makes the save. For entrepreneurs who just won't take no for an answer, they get a second chance special. Another shot at scoring a lucrative deal on Dragon's Den Wednesday. Halfway through the third period in Vancouver. Red Wings and the Vancouver Canucks, neither very comfortable about their position in the standings, although they're both in the playoffs. Stanton. Kevin Bieksa held the puck in. Zach Cassian cycles back. Brad Richardson does the same thing for Sean Mathias. Bounced one off the back of that, trying to work it in front, and there's going to be a penalty here. And the Red Wings get in on the hands of Sean Mathias. There'll be a hooking call against Denny DeKaiser, and Vancouver gets the power play.
You've talked about Sean Mathias all night. You've said his name numerous times, and this is just an excellent job protecting the puck, staying on it. And DeKaiser, once you get your stick caught in there, it's almost impossible to get it out. You've lost the physical position. Mathias does a nice job of turning himself around and keeping the puck alive, and there's no doubt about that penalty call there.
Well, Vancouver's been perfect on the penalty kill. They've had one power play goal. If they can get another one, that might be enough to win this game. Sedin and Verbata in the first power play unit on the ice, but they'll have to go back and collect the puck. Alex Edler. Yeah, Drew Miller race down and make him make a hasty decision. He's not going to have time to think about what he does, so he moves it right around. Daniel Sedin gave it back. Henrik falls in behind Edler, takes the drop pass. Had an open man on the other side, but he gave the puck to Daniel. Daniel in for Henrik. Burrows headed for the front of the net. Here's Daniel to Henrik, back to the blue line. Alexander Edler, screenshot that came off Jimmy Howard to the corner. Henrik Sedin to Daniel, to the open man in the corner. Radim Verbata walks out, shoots. Great save, Howard. Rebound, he scores! Radim Verbata! Second power play goal of the night for the Canucks. A huge goal in a 2-0 lead.
One of the set plays they have here is watch the top of your screen. Verbata gets lost because if they get pressured out, the Sedins want to have an outlet, and that's a hard wraparound. Look at how deep in the corner he is. It's almost like he's a forgotten soul. Comes out with one chance. A rebound was there for a split second. And this is one of those plays that Jimmy Howard thought he had, but Drew Miller actually knocks it right out of his hand. Poor timing there, but great opportunity for Verbata.
Nyquist scoops the puck wide. Red Wings now have some work to do, trailing 2-0 to Vancouver. Yannick Hansen at center, trying to get away from DeKaiser. Good to see a good foot race between those two. They're great skaters, both of them. Riley Sheehan with Tatar and Nyquist. Turn back in the neutral zone. Yannick Hansen has the puck, and he shot it back in. And Vancouver and Detroit both make changes. Abdelkader, Pavel Datsyuk, one on two. No magic there this time. Bo Horvat, look at him get his legs going. Throws the puck in front, tipped twice, and then in behind the net. Burrell's got a piece of it, and so did Derek Dorsett. Fourth line against first after the power play here. And an offside call, and that's a pretty good get through it shift for the Vancouver Canucks. Radim Verbata with a power play goal. Little insurance for Vancouver with a ways to go, his 16th of the year. It's a big power play goal for Vancouver for the Red Wings, and Drew Miller, an unfortunate series of events.
Yeah, without question, the best intentions for Miller. He comes diving back in to help out, but inadvertently knocks it right out of his goaltender's hand. Howard's in good position. He's ready to get right on top of it. Instead, it's Miller who takes it away, and oh boy, Teresa Miller, very tough. The torn thoughts of Vancouver and Detroit, who wins, who loses. And seeing Drew knock that puck away, you can see her reaction is a difficult one.
Older brother, Ryan, has a 2-0 lead. Zach Cassian for Vancouver. Watch how careful they will be, or probably should be, with the puck. That's what their coach is thinking at this point in the game, with a 2-0 lead against Detroit. Still forechecking.
Their last shift was a big one, Jim. It gave them the power play to get that goal.
And they're back at it again. They talked about, heard Kristana talk about it in the first intermission. Don't take your foot off the gas. Spezza with his shot, and he hit Cassian with that shot. Darren Helm overskated the puck. Weber to the front of the net. Xavier Ouellette is there again. Helm stripped to the puck by Zach Cassian. Sean Mathias to the front of the net. Xavier Ouellette, who's made some good plays tonight, made another one with his stick, but he tipped the puck out of play.
Well, if the Vancouver Canucks are going to be a playoff team and going far, they need that depth. They need that push from a line other than the Sedins. And Sean Mathias, Willie Desjardins felt when he got hit in Toronto back in early December, it sort of knocked him back a little bit. He was playing some of his best hockey, and I would say the coach would be very happy with the way that that line has come together tonight, and especially here in the third.
And the top line hasn't disappointed, especially on the power play. Five on five, they played the Datsyuk line to a stalemate.
And there's the real challenge when you got two really good special team teams. Can you win that battle? And on home ice, Vancouver so far has done so.
Three big penalty kills, two big power play goals. Tanev up the boards. Abdelkader intercepted. Tanev stopped him again. Radim Vrbata safely out into the neutral zone. And the Sedin's shift is over. In comes Abdelkader. Datsyuk. A deflected shot to the corner. Alex Edler is back. Referees in the way, Brad Watson. Extricates himself from the scrum and the Canucks break out. Danik Hansen. Chris Higgins has Nick Bonino in front. Hansen held the puck in. Gus Nyquist. Kyle Quincy to Thomas Tatar, whose speed pulls him away from the pack. Now he goes to the net. Nyquist stops up, tried to feed the puck in front. It hit a Canuck. From the blue line to Kaiser, held it in. Faked a shot over to Kyle Quincy. Big crowd in front. Here's DeKaiser, takes the shot that went off Ryan Stanton and out of play. Down to 5:45 to go in the third period. Vancouver ahead of Detroit 2-0 on Hockey Night in Canada on CBC. In a bid to get his 20th win of the season, you could tell right from the opening faceoff tonight that Ryan Miller was on his game.
He was sharp and his teammates followed suit. A couple of anxious moments around the crease, fighting for loose pucks. Huge save on his younger brother, Drew, early in that first period when the tips were coming. He was all over the puck. Zetterberg, Datsyuk putting pressure. At this point, 27 saves, and many of them like that. Acrobatic, with traffic in front of him, moving laterally, and very sharp on the puck.
Half a dozen of those saves in the third period when the Red Wings had two consecutive power plays. And with that faceoff win, Vancouver has just forged ahead. It was 50-50 in the faceoffs after Detroit's had a pretty good third period. Henrik Zetterberg. Backhand pass for Vrbata, tipped it. Datsyuk gets it, takes a shot, and Ryan Miller stops the puck.
Well, you always take strength from your goaltender. I know as a player, when you looked in the crease and you saw your goalie was sharp, you had more of a jump in your stride. And Willie Desjardins this morning just felt that his team needed as a whole to be sharp. This is a good team to be coming in on the heels of losing to the defending champs, to have a team like Detroit that is such a good puck control team. I think his group has really responded well.
Richardson just won his eighth faceoff, but going straight ahead was Nyquist. He got it back for a moment. And now he tries to do it again. Richardson out for the draw with Thorsen and Burrows. Alex Burrows to Brad Richardson, and safely out into the neutral zone. Burrows tracks the puck down, throws it in front, Stanton with a shot. And a good stick by Riley Sheahan, the centerman coming back to prevent a good opportunity. Long shoot in from center by Kevin Bieksa, stopped by Jimmy Howard. Brandon Smith, Xavier Ouellette. Safely shoots the puck in. Johan Kronson in first against Spezza. Steven Weiss is there. Throws the puck back to the blue line. Cronwall on his offside. Had to go to his backhand and he couldn't hold the puck in. Weiss, Helm, and Kronson. Coming down to a three-line game now for Mike Babcock. All of his offensive players will play the last 4 minutes. Here's Cronwall with some room, takes a shot of a rolling puck, blocked by Nick Bonino. And out to center, Chris Higgins dumps the puck in short shifts to try and finish this for Vancouver. They change again.
And you wonder how long it'll be before Howard comes out. Right now, Mike Babcock's trying to get his attention. He's yelling down the bench to try to get the goaltender's attention.
Nyquist to center and in over the blue line, Justin Abdelkader.
And now here he comes.
Here goes Howard to the bench for the extra attacker, and it's Thomas Tatar who comes on. Datsyuk. Nyquist, Zetterberg, Tatar, Abdelkader, and back at the blue line. Puck's held in by Danny DeKeyser. Here's a quick shot. Score! Thomas Tatar! What a shot! A great battle won on the boards by the Red Wings, DeKeyser to Tatar, and it's a 2-1 game with 3.5 to go.
Jim, this is just a spectacular play on the blue line by Danny DeKeyser. So many defensemen, young defensemen, would try to knock this down with a stick. It's a bouncing puck, a one-hopper. Gets it down with his glove, doesn't throw it away. Back to Nyquist, traffic in front. Edler's battling with Abdelkader, but look at the ability to just keep presence of mind, settle it down, and more importantly, not throw it away. Bats it back down, Nyquist makes the save. Look at the positioning in front by Abdelkader. The late reaction by Miller, he never saw it till he heard the crowd's reaction.
Tatar from Nyquist and DeKeyser. And it's a 2-1 game, and Jimmy Howard is back in the net. And it was Tatar who came off the bench for Howard when he was pulled. Whether or not the opponents can come back in this building tonight, we don't know, but we know we're in for a fantastic finish with under 3 minutes to go. Yannick Hansen, backhanded the puck in. Nick Bonino up against DeKeyser. Pavel Datsyuk back for the puck. Xavier Ouellette. I think Babcock's playing the rookie a lot in a game where he needs a goal late.
He's been great, hasn't he? He's been around the play all over, both offensively and defensively.
Puck got away from Datsyuk. Alex Edler is back for Vancouver. Hard backhander around to Verbata. And Cronwall couldn't hold the line. A puck will go all the way down. This is an icing call against Vancouver. 2:18 to go in the third. Both teams have their timeout.
Ryan, looks like Babcock's not going to wait, and here's why. He pulled the goalie at the appropriate time. He had a chance going in offensively. Nyquist throws it back. Good bouncer, and as you mentioned, a great one-timer. Look at the positioning and the readiness of Tatar. He had the stick up, waving in the air as the puck came across, so there was no hesitation. And now we've got the extra attacker out again for the Red Wings. Delays the faceoff, which actually helps Canucks a little bit get settled.
Six attackers inside the line. The Red Wings got the puck back. Cronwall got a break. And then he threw the puck outside the line. Franzen was supposed to be over on the other side. At least Cronwall thought he was. Sedins and Radim Verbata are on the ice. Steven Weiss gains the attacking line, dumps the puck in. Riley Sheahan in after Alex Edler, who didn't know where the puck was. He'd overskated it. Comes loose in some feet. Daniel Sedin, what a play. Henrik Sedin hits the net. A 160 feet from the goal. They're still making those special plays. Daniel to Henrik, empty netter, 3-1 Canucks.
It's 200th goal, but man, that's a risky play. You know it's great and everybody's celebrating when it goes in the back of the net. So often you make this split-second decision. Do I carry it and lose it? Nope. Know exactly what I'm going to do. Hadn't scored in 13, but showed a lot of confidence there. Because, Jim, I can guarantee if there's a face-off back here again on an icing call, could have been a very different ending.
His 200th National Hockey League goal after 13 games without. Missed on a breakaway tonight, and I guess that's why he's not in the shootouts. But he's pretty good on those empty netters. Daniel Sedin and Alex Edler get the assists.
You got two penalties here. Smith is going to get a trip, and Dorsett, I think, a high stick. And with a minute 41, hey, you never know. There's lots of hockey to go.
These are the Red Wings, and you know what happened in Los Angeles earlier today with three goals inside of 2 minutes for Los Angeles to send the game to overtime.
Yeah, there's the trip, and then the stick coming up on the trip got into the face of Smith, so both goal. You know, it's live or die by that early goaltender pull. You've got situation, Jim, early with 4 minutes left. They pulled it when they were down by two. It worked. It was 2:18. That was a lot of time on an offensive zone faceoff, but Mike Babcock felt he'd have a chance.
A 2-1 game. Could Henrik have made center ice? Maybe.
I think he could have, but probably not have got a shot away at the net.
Doesn't matter now.
If you're money on that shot, who cares, right? It's only if you miss it. Great players never think they're going to miss anything.
Here they come again with the net empty. That is a two-goal deficit again for the Red Wings. Thatcher got the puck. Cronwall takes the shot. Hit his old man, Nyquist. Big pileup in front of the net. And a wrestling match between Edner and Abdelkader. They're going at it. And the referees finally had to stop the play.
Just tuck this one in the back of your mind when you see little ticky-tack calls with a stick into the body area and you go, that shouldn't be a call. These two guys were hog-tying each other as Abdelkader was trying to get to the net. Edler was just not going to let it happen.
They're both going to go.
Watch this battle out of the corner. Tied up here. Could have called both way. Abdelkader tried to draw the penalty, didn't get it. Then the officials let them go at it for a while, and once it was clear, the helmets were off, and the whistle had to go.
Well, the Canucks lose their best defenseman. The Red Wings lose one of their best net front presences with a two-goal deficit.
They're trying to decide where... They were trying to decide where the faceoff was going to go, but they're both going to go off the ice now, it looks like.
Abdelkader's cut. So he's headed for the dressing room. So this will be 5-on-4 as the Red Wings pull their goaltender, Jimmy Howard, again. With a faceoff in the attacking zone, Pavel Datsyuk will take the draw against Nick Bonino. Datsyuk has Nyquist and Zetterberg on his left, Riley Sheahan, another centerman on his right, Cronwall, the defenseman. And another big draw by Nick Bonino. He won a couple on the penalty kill in the third period, early in the third period. They were huge. Now he's sent the Red Wings back to center. On the fly on the regroup, here comes Henrik Zetterberg, snapped the shot and just missed in the last minute of the third period. Alex Burrows with a two-goal lead, backhand of the puck, and it's ruled that Nick Cronwall knocked it out of the air with a high stick with 54 seconds left.
That's a really important game for the Vancouver Canucks. As you mentioned, so tight is the race in the Western Conference. You've got a team in Detroit that has done well, obviously, playing here for so many years. They're 5-1-1 coming in, but a really solid effort top to bottom here for the Canucks on home ice.
Couple of days off. The Islanders are next in their homestand on Tuesday. Detroit goes off to Calgary and Edmonton in this road trip. They'll stay here for another day. They're still thinking a couple of goals here. In comes Cronwall. Puck's chipped by him. Henrik, another open net. Goal 201. And the Vancouver Canucks have a 4-1 lead.
I think it's payoff, too, for the good all-around game, both offensively and defensively, by the Sedins in this game, that preserving the two-goal lead at the time, the Willie Desjardins pays it off and allows them to play in that situation.
They were good all night in a matchup against great players. And in the special teams battle tonight, Kenny Holland's team lost to Vancouver. Vancouver with three big penalty kills and two power play goals. Drew Miller. There's a shot, another great save by Ryan Miller with Drew Miller right in his face. In the dying seconds, the two brothers came together after another fine Ryan Miller save. And this will be Ryan's first outright win over his brother Drew. And he was spectacular. But a big bounce back effort tonight for the Vancouver Canucks against a very good team. Vancouver 4 and Detroit 1. Teresa Miller, as the brothers come together in the crease. And Ryan gets a small measure of revenge against his brother. Three stars tonight. Ryan Miller, very deserving of the first. Alexander Edler scored the first goal for Vancouver and was their best defenseman and one of their best players all night. And Pavel Datsyuk didn't have enough magic to get his team back into a tie and send it to overtime, but he was great to watch tonight. Ryan Miller gets the win. The Vancouver Canucks have defeated the Red Wings, and George and the panel will have lots more hockey on Hockey Night in Canada after this.